He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Congratulations, you've got a newborn baby. And since you've become so proficient in building physics apparatus, you decide to try your hand at building baby stuff. Your first task is to build a mobile of the solar system. This is your proposed plan for the mobile, with all the arm lengths given. If we approximate the arms and string as being massless, what must the weights of all the planets be in order for every single arm to balance in precise horizontal fashion, given that Mercury has a weight of 5 newtons? To answer this, we need to understand torque. So check out my tutorial on this subject if you need to. Otherwise, let's get to building. What we must recall is that the torque that is produced by a force, whether it is an applied force or the force of gravity, is proportional to the length of the lever arm. That's why sitting further away from the fulcrum of a seesaw allows you to lift a person that's much heavier than you if they are sitting closer to the fulcrum. The precise relationship is that the force times the length of the lever arm on one side will be equal to the force times the length of the lever arm on the other side, if equilibrium is to be maintained, since the positive torque and negative torque must cancel each other out. So let's split this mobile up into 7 systems, and start at the bottom with what we know. Looking at system 7, Mercury has a weight of 5 newtons. The lever arm is the same length on both sides, so Venus must also have a weight of 5 newtons. Now for system 5 above, the total weight on the right side is 10 newtons. So we multiply by 12 centimeters, divide by the 8 centimeter length on the other side, and we get 15 newtons for the weight of Uranus. Let's go up one system again to system 3. The right side has a total weight of 25 newtons at this point. Multiply this by the 20 centimeter length of the lever arm and divide by the 25 centimeter lever arm on the other side. And that means this whole left side must have a weight of 20 newtons. Since the arm in system 4 is split up into equal halves, then we can split that weight in half. So Saturn must be 10 newtons, and these two must add up to 10 newtons. Given the 4 centimeter and 6 centimeter lengths for system 6, we could do a little algebra, or we could just see that Neptune must be 6 newtons and Mars must be 4 newtons. Almost done now. Systems 3 through 7 have a combined weight of 45 newtons. So we can multiply that by this 10 centimeter length and then divide by the 30 centimeter length on the other side. And we see that Jupiter must have a weight of 15 newtons. Lastly, that gives all of this a combined weight of 60 newtons. So we multiply by 10 and then divide by 30 and we get 20 newtons as the weight of the Sun. With all of these weights, we could simply divide by the acceleration due to gravity to get the respective masses, which means dividing by roughly 10, and that will give us kilogram values to make sure our planets are just right to make this thing look great. This kid's going to be an astronaut, I bet. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.